السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. أهلا وسهلا بكم مرة تانية. ويلكم دير برادرز أند دير سيسترز أجين. إن شاء الله وستيل إن شاء الله توكن أباوت ذيس كايند أوف جن أند وي سي هاو أند واي ذا جن إنتر ذا بودي أوف ذا هيومن بينج. واي أند وين. واي أند وين. It's good to know because if you know, I'm sure you're gonna have some kind of preparation. You're gonna prepare yourself not to be one of these people which is being affected by jinn. Ibn Taymiyyah, rahimahullah, Shaykh al-Islam, says, jinn being created by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala like us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he made taklif for them. He said, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. They have taklif. They will be asked in the day of judgment. They will be accountable. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives them also choice. They are making sin like us. See, subhanallah. They are exactly like us. You see, some of even the human beings, they are wronging one another without any reason. The same thing is jinn, they are wronging one another and they are wronging us without any reason. Just because he hates you. Jinn, yes, because if he hates you, that's why he can possess you and he can hurt and harm you. This is one of the reasons. Number two, because al-jinn in love with you. Yes, al-jinn can love you. Yeah, the women of jinn, they can love you as a man. As a man of a human, of the human. You know. And but mostly, the men of jinn, they possess most of the human women. They love women so much, and they, especially nowadays, especially because women now, they are showing their bodies and they are not taking care of themselves and they don't have Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim in their life. That's why al-jinn in love, they call عشق الجن للإنس. See, when the sister goes here, go to her bedroom, subhanAllah, and she's in her house, mostly without any clothes, without anything like this, naked or nude. And also, and you see her also, subhanAllah, is not saying Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim or anything. Al-jinn is watching. Jinn is watching and he's enjoying. And sometimes because he get the عشق and love to that lady, or to that woman, he likes her body, he enter, he possess her, subhanAllah. That's why when you take your clothes off, say Bismillah. When you enter the bathroom, أعوذ بالله من الخبث والخبائث. You know, all of these, subhanAllah, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم instructed us already. This is second reason, العشق, yeah. See, some sister, they come to us even after her marriage. Her husband cannot, subhanAllah, making intercourse with her, and he cannot even touch her because of the jinn. She has jinn in her body, and maybe she could recognize it or not. And sometimes some sister said, Sheikh, every night I feel somebody like making intercourse with me in my dream, yeah, when I sleep. This is too much, means that she been possessed, she has jinn in her body, yeah, subhanAllah. And the jinn, even when her husband comes to like that special relationship with her, you see, subhanAllah, there is some kind of sudda, her private part being blocked. He cannot do anything because of the jinn. Number three, jinn enter our bodies, I said, because he hates us, because he loves us, and because sometimes intentionally we harm al-jinn without any, يعني, subhanAllah, intentional, يعني, accidentally, like what we said. Somehow, when you step on them and you put like hot water for them, that's why Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, when you go to the bathroom, say, أعوذ بالله من الخبث والخبائث. Say, غفرانك, when you get out, enter the bathroom with your left foot. Very important, you know. These three reasons, al-jinn, they enter the body of the human being. And when al-jinn, I said that the reasons. Well, now I'm talking about when al-jinn enter the body of the human being. Number one, when you become very, very, very extremely excessive, angry. Yeah, extremely angry. SubhanAllah. That's why Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, La taghdab. And a'lam kalima, I know a word when Rasul sallam said about that sahabi. I know a word. If he said it, shaitan will go away from him. Said, if you say, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. Yes, when you see somebody mad, see his face turn red, and you see that a lot of saliva comes out from his mouth, and this, subhanAllah, he's so mad. Say, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. Don't be mad, because when you become mad, you have no power, you have no control. Shaitan will come and jinn will overpower your body. And that's why Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, if when you get mad, if you are sitting, stand, if you are standing, sit down or walk or change that, subhanAllah, the condition where you are, where are you, like this, you know, or make wudu or go take a cold shower or anything like that, your anger will go away from you. That's why shaitan will not overpower you. Number two, when shaitan will enter our body, when we fear a lot. You see some brother or sisters extremely in fear from anything. That's why shaitan will find very easy ride to to ride that body, because that fear a lot. If you want to fear from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't worry about anybody. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will protect you. Say, A'udhu billahi minash shaitan rajim. Shaitan cannot come to you. Why are you afraid? Why you have that fear, you know? Sometimes people, because of that fear, they cannot sleep at all. And my advice to the parents also, sometimes now we get that scary movies to our kids, and they watch these scary movies and they go to their bed and they see a lot of bad dreams, and that comes in their conscious, you know, for long term, they cannot live. They're gonna have that kind of fear all the time. That's why, dear brothers, wallahi, sisters, be careful. Number three, when shaitan can come to your body, when you are heedless, الغفلة الشديدة, excessive headless, you know, when you are غافل, completely away, and as I said that before, وَمَنْ يَعْشُ عَنْ ذِكَرَ الرَّحْمَنِ نُقَيِّدْ لَهُ شَيْطَانًا فَهُ لَهُ قَرِينٌ. If you are, subhanAllah, away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's remembrance, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will appoint shaitan, and he will be your qareen, he will be your friend, he will be with you all the time, subhanAllah. So much, subhanAllah. Also, number four, when you will be into your desires, means so much into the scene, يعني subhanAllah, when when you have that special relationship with your wife, الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم teach us how to say اللهم جنب بسم الله اللهم جنبنا الشيطان وجنب الشيطان ما رزقتنا. Even to say بسم الله when you are making intercourse with a wife. Oh Allah, avoid us shaitan and avoid our kids from, يعني سبحان الله الشيطان too. Very important يا جماعة to think about this. Don't go to your desires a lot, excessive love to your desires and all of that. يعني so much into the scene, like what I said, you know. Don't think about it too much, because more desires, more lusts, more desires, and you will live in your desires like this, and you're gonna be ghafil, you're gonna love your desires more than anything. This is gonna be your hawa, you're gonna be your God. أَفَرَأَيْتَ مَنِ اتَّخَذَ إِلَاهَهُ هَوَى وَضَلَّهُ اللَّهُ عَلَى عِلْمٍ فَأَنْتَ تَكُونُ عَلَيْهُ كِلَى. سبحان الله. فلذلك يا جماعة, also make dua. Dua is very important. Dua يعني will help you a lot. This the way how shaitan will enter our bodies, and when shaitan will enter our bodies, as I said, when you get so mad, when you get so angry, so mad, when you fear a lot, and you when you are heedless, غفلة شديدة, and also when you subhanAllah will be so much into your desires and your lusts, and subhanAllah, and that will take your heart away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when you will become very sad, الحزن الشديد, very sad, and or excessive sadness, or excessive happiness, or excessive anger, or excessive fear, all of these, subhanAllah, shaitan, you have no control in your body. That's why shaitan will overpower you when you will be in these situations. Dear brothers, dear sisters, really, think about that. You have to know that the doors of shaitan, you have to lock these doors, and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect you. And sisters, cover yourself, sisters. Don't show your body all the time, even inside your house. You know, because the shaitan will attack you. Say, A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Say, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Put Surah Al-Baqarah, Surah Al-Saffat. Read, قل هو الله أحد. قل read, قل عذو رب الناس. Read, قل عذو رب الفقر. قل عذو رب الفلق. Read all of these ayat. Read these surahs. Subhanallah. And make ruqya for yourself. Say, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Do your salah, make zikr. These, subhanAllah, things, or these ibadat, or kind of active worship, anyway, you have to do it. But this is for your own benefit. Your ibadah will not benefit Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wallahi, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He give us this kind of ibadat just to benefit our own selves. This is for our own protection. This is a system of Allah, the law of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah knows, but you don't know. Wallahu ya'lam. و وأنتم لا تعلمون. أسكن الله سبحانه وتعالى to protect all of us. إن شاء الله follow me. إن شاء الله go to my playlist. I'm gonna put these episodes إن شاء الله all under how to protect yourself from the jinn. إن شاء الله. And listen to it. Know the keys. Protect your family. Protect yourselves, especially those who've been possessed by jinn. I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give them speedy recovery and to protect them and their families and our kids. Ameen ya Rab, from shaitan al-insul jinn. Ameen ya Rab al-ameen. Your brother Sayyid Jum'ah, share this video. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.